So why no kissing for 3 months? Has anybody heard this rule yet?
Yeah.
And why you don't want to kiss for 3 months is because the person that you're dating is a stranger. You don't know anything about him. You don't know if he's telling you the truth about his marital status. You don't know if he's telling you the truth about where he lives. You don't know if he's consistent, if the person he is today is going to be the same person he's going to be in 3 months. And what happens when we get caught up in the wrong relationships is, again, men are driven biologically the same way we are, right? They want to procreate. They have a strong procreation drive. And they're very happy to draw you into physical intimacy early because it satisfies his needs and urges. But men are also happy to wait to satisfy those needs and urges. If you say to a guy, I'm not going to kiss for 3 months, a guy is going to say, I don't have 3 months. I need instant gratification. That's too long for me to wait. That's what a guy is going to say. And you know what you're going to say when he says that? Yeah, exactly. Because that's not what you want. You want a long-term relationship, which means that you want somebody who can go through things with you. If it's difficult, he can go through it with you. Now, waiting 3 months for a kiss is not easy. Trust me, I have done it. It's not easy when you're very attracted and there's a lot of chemistry. So if he can do this with you, then there's a lot more that he can accomplish with you. It's just, this is one of the things that lets you see, can this man stand the test of time? Can he put himself aside for my emotional well-being? Can he accept what my goals are, what I want to achieve? Does he support me in what I want? Because what you want is a long-term, loving, supportive relationship. And a guy, he needs his stuff right away. So he's going to go, because that's not the person who is going to give you a long-term, supportive, loving relationship. So waiting for 3 months gives a man an opportunity to prove himself to you. So you can date multiple men at once. Why? Because you're not kissing. We have this thing, this cultural norm. How many of you can date more than one man at once if you're kissing more than one man at once? Most women don't. For us, we seal it with a kiss. And so when we start kissing somebody, we don't date other men. So when you don't kiss, if you meet another man who's interesting to you, you can go on dates. And you simply say, I like you. These are the qualities I like about you. But I don't get involved with somebody that I don't know. And it takes time to get to know somebody. It takes time to figure somebody out. And so I wait 3 months. And here's the date today. Here's 3 months from today. And if we're still dating each other, and if this has just been building and getting better, then we'll kiss on this date. And men get that because men are selective too. Guys, again, they don't like that. They need it right here, right now. So, yes?
What if the guy just dates you once a month for 3 months?
Well, what do you want? Do you want the kind of partner who's around once a month?
No.
Right, so then you say goodbye.
So.
And the thing is, but you can date him, but don't kiss him, mm-hmm. Right? And keep dating other people. You're not locked in.
I'm still looking.
Yeah. So when you're doing this whole no kissing for 3 months, but I'm going to date you kind of thing, you can hold hands, you can cuddle, you can touch, you know, and I say touch his shoulder, touch his arm, touch his face, touch his neck, touch his chest, touch his leg, just touch, it's okay. As much as you want to touch him, no kissing and no sleepovers keeps you from getting too deep into a relationship before you figure out who he is. But you're allowed to grow fonder of him. You're allowed to create oxytocin and feel that and enjoy it and love it. You know, you're allowed to become intimate because that's what all this is about. It's about creating intimacy. It's just you're not confusing yourself by introducing sexuality. Because what happens when you have sexuality, that aphrodisiac, it's more oxytocin than you can handle. You sleep less, but you're not tired. That's how much oxytocin is in your body and dopamine. And so what happens is red flags come up and you don't see them So when you don't kiss for 3 months, you see the red flags more clearly. You have a more objective view on the situation, and you're better able to say, this isn't for me. Thank you for watching. Find me on social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and also www.canadasdatingcoach.com.